Bates with the night edition of News in Depth. Welcome and thank you for joining us.
Tina and Mona are apologizing for their outburst against the ranks of the Rosehout Police Outpost and the embarrassment the incident has caused them and their families. The two young women who became internet sensations overnight are now getting help to deal with issues of mental health. The women in an interview today said while not justifying their actions, they want the public to know that they have suffered traumatic experiences which include rape and domestic violence.
Apologize to everyone for the racial slangs and the way that we behave. Okay, well, depression is a mental illness and it is very hard to cope with. It makes you lose appetite, make you lose sleep, interest in everything, in daily activities. And there's a lot of things contribute to my depression. I recently go through a divorce. Then recently my ex put up a video with me and that triggered me a lot.
I'm really depressed right now, frustrated. And I would like to apologize to the people near my call and the racism stuff that I throw on the police them. I'm not racist, but I would like to apologize to the whole country and everybody.
The women reached out to several persons, including Minister of Youth Affairs Simona Broome, who facilitated the help of a trauma and moral injury specialist, Sharmin Prince.
It's amazing that we saw the video. We saw the anger, we saw the frustration, we saw all the labels that we can think about. But the thing is, there is a lot of underlying trauma occurring in both Mona's and Tina's life. For Mona, Mona shared about being raped. Mona is a victim or a survivor. I would say a victim because she's not a survivor yet of domestic violence.
Minister Broome said she could not refuse the cries of help from the two women.
I cannot have two young girls reaching out to me for help and turning a deaf ear or a blind eye. I have to stop and pause and give them a hearing and to give them support, guidance, and advice. That is all they need. They're not here because they need blood. They're not here because they need money. They're here because they believe, yes, we might have done wrong. Wrong was meted out to us, but we're not focusing on what was meted out to us alone. Mona said, I want to have peace. You know, I want to feel free. I want to look at the world and not to see the world staring at me in condemnation.
Currently, the women are facing 10 charges in the court.
More news after the break. Stay with us.
Right now, we're having a major protest outside of Comfort Street. Let's talk to the protesters.
What is going on? Comfort Street taking long for have the next 10 sale. How long we got to wait for the next sale, man? Since the last big 10 sale, I saving up all my money.
Because I didn't get all I want.
Them other mattresses, when them people are selling, I can't sleep comfortable from them. You understand? Because Comfort Street know that I got the best quality than the rest. So how long people got to wait for sleeping comfort?
And besides, I'll be saving up my money long now for them nice deals. We're supposed to come just now. I'll be one nice
about okay, else. Okay. Comfort Sleep is putting on the best sale ever. Best mattresses.
Bed sets.
Best quality. Best price and more. Plus win prizes on the spot, including a fabulous bed set.
The 14th of December,
7 a.m. to 5 p.m. at Comfort Sleep, 409 Eccles Industrial Estate, East Bank, Demerara.
Well, I'll be just sitting on it. Feel this.
Comfort Sleep. The best by test.
All-in-one weapon for perfecting imperfections and capturing flawless skin. A lot of brands forget women of color or just don't understand that we come in all shades. From caramel to ebony, there's such a range. Iman Cosmetics is for every woman and features a line of skincare products and cosmetics including 16 foundation shades, powder, concealer, lipstick, blush, eyeshadow, highlighter, and BB cream. Visit us at Lot 75, Swamp Section, Rosal Town. That's behind the market. Or call 337-4422 or 688-9249. Shh.
Wouldn't it be nice if we didn't have so much waste to dispose of in the landfill? Well, composting can help us reduce the waste we dispose of by turning our organic waste into compost, which can be used to improve the quality of our soil.
Composting is very simple and convenient.
You can compost using organic waste such as vegetable skins,
or fallen leaves and cut grass, and put this in a composting bin or pile.
Compost can help your garden grow healthy plants
while reducing your volume of waste. It's a really good way to keep our communities clean and healthy.
So, let's all start composting our waste.
Find out how easy it is. Call us on 226-2189 or 227-8429 or visit our website, moc.gov.gy. A message from the Ministry of Communities in collaboration with the Inter-American Development Bank.
Beer.
Welcome back.
Jacqueline Hunter, the mother of the missing murder witness, Colin Rodney, is looking for closure weeks after the police took DNA samples from the remains found in his car. The woman said she's still waiting on the results, and it is becoming burdensome. The woman was emotional as she spoke to the media.
The 25th October, he missing. They find the body in the forest. If I didn't get me child, he would have done buried. I'd have done overcome this thing. Get me child till now. How them think I feeling? I only looking like if I feeling good. Every day, every morning, every night I wake up, I scream, Miss Stephen, no, let me child out there. Now me get people put in the resting place. Nobody looking at me direction. I just ask them, go and ask the crime chief, Mr. Kingston. I asked him, I said, I just beg if you could bring down me child from the part where I got you up there, put you up like no response up to now. Nobody helping me, nobody. But I just want to know. I know election time coming around and the rancho, everybody's wired for them time. Nobody's looking in my direction. Nobody. You feel how I feel that how I can't bury me child? Me looking for aid from nobody. Me looking for sympathy. Me looking for help. But I just show you. My child was kidnapped and murdered by whoever and not a soul. Nobody never come and say, well, you gave me sympathy. Nobody. They're here now. I still grieving up to now. I just ask them, bring me child down from the party there and put it like in nobody in my direction. Nobody. I just left now like sad movie. I don't know what to do.
You would recall that the chassis number matched that of the missing murder witness car. A body that was burnt beyond recognition was found in the trunk of the car at letter T, Mike. It is believed that the remains are that of Colin Rodney, who vanished on his way to court to give evidence in his cousin's murder trial. The woman said after she gave the DNA sample, she was told that she would have the results in 3 weeks.
3 weeks is almost a month and a half now. Me get no answer. No answer, none.
They didn't call you to update
nobody
you?
Nobody don't call me. Nobody don't call me. I stand me calling by myself. I grieving by myself because it's me child. Nobody never call me. Nobody never come for ask me nothing. Since me child daddy owns his body, I can see as he made your house is there.
Rodney was a taxi driver. and also the main witness in the murder case of his cousin, Marlon Rodney, called George. Rodney was killed between April 25th and 30th last at Norton Street Lodge. Two men, Osafa Grundell and James Fraser, are currently on trial in the Georgetown Magistrates Court for the offense.
With that, we've come to the end of tonight's newscast. If you have a news story or tip, you can contact us on 666-4337 or 654-0523. You can also visit our website at www.rdproductiongy.com or on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Royce and Tricks Production for more details on these and other stories.